Sorry I got you into this.
I could have stayed in the car.
Boxer's fracture.
Do I need a cast?
Splint's fine. Just keep it elevated and iced.
How's Skaggett?
He's got a couple of broken ribs, an orbital fracture, and a concussion. And he's gonna need a plastic surgeon to stitch up his cheek. It's gonna be a while before I can get to you.
We're backed up. I'm gonna need the room. You can wait down at the nurse's lounge. I'll come get you.
Thank you.
That guy, Skaggett, he the one that beat up your mother?
Yep.
She's back.
Who?
Your mother. Came in about 10 minutes ago. She's down with that guy that beat her up.
Mother.
You could have killed him!
I should have killed the guy!
I told you, stay away from him!
How can you let him treat you like this, Ma? How can you let him treat you like
this? It's my life.
It's my life,
too. It's my life, too, Mom!
You know what? He won't hit you again. You know why? Because I stopped it. I couldn't stop it with Dad, but I stopped it with this bastard.
This has nothing to do with me and your father.
Oh, no?
No.
Oh, no?
No, your father and I had trouble. We worked through it.
Worked through them? What a joke! It was a damn prize fight. How could you leave us there watching all that? I was 10 years old. And Mike was 8 years old.
You were always the most important thing in my life. I love you and your brother very much.
You didn't love us enough from keeping us from watching all that. I got a question for you. Have you filed charges against this bastard yet? Huh? Are you in there begging him to keep you around? That's what I thought. You know what? I'm not 10 years old anymore, Mom. Somebody hits my mother, they're gonna get a beating whether you like it or not.
Maurice.
Bosco.
Yeah.
Christopher called and he wants us back at the house. Skaggett's gonna file assault charges against you.